The U.S. on the verge of making it to the Grand Prix final in a season of adversity. She lost her coach midway through the season, and no one would have blamed her for taking some time away from the ice, but she made the decision to continue throughout the Grand Prix and on to Japan.
Well, I set a plan before I started the season, and I knew that I had to do Nations Cup, and then I had a plan to go straight to St. Petersburg and train there for a week and then compete at Cup of Russia and come here and skate in Japan. And I really like Japan and I like skating here, and I feel like with every competition I'm getting stronger and stronger, so why not, you know, go out there and get the program out as many times as I can, so it'll just make me feel more comfortable when I have to go out at Nationals and try and qualify for the Olympic team.
What will the entire lineup look like for that final? Well, we're about to find out. Yoshie Yanda has the lead over Ann Patrice McDonough and Fumie Suguri. But here is the leader after the short program, Angela Nikodinov, looking for her third straight medal in the Grand Prix. ...14 points overall in the Grand Prix. This is a non-scoring event for her, as we said, so she can't gain any points, but she sure can't keep others from acquiring them.
It's all about timing for her at this point, not to rush this takeoff. Double Lutz, oh dear, double Lutz right there. Double toe loop. She's falling short of rotation.
Here, she definitely goes to the Grand Prix final, but above and beyond that, it would be her first ever gold medal in the Grand Prix series.
But look at the grace and beauty she has within this music. Very sophisticated. Got to keep the timing and not rush the takeoff on this triple flip, and then it'll come together, and it worked there. And then another double.
And remember, there are two more skaters to go who both control their own destiny. Shenko, Tatiana Malinina round out the top three, and if either one of those wins the free skate, they win the gold.
Here's the second, and there's a single. So she did a double at the beginning, and then, worst of all, a single. Deep in the program.
Yeah. Well, we'll have to wait and see.
Yeah, that's too bad. But I tell you, she's been through a lot, and it's tough to keep everything together under pressure like this. Only two clean triples in her program. Far short of what she was hoping to do. One of the jumps that worked well for Angela was the triple loop that takes off the right backward outside edge. You just edge off that. There's no foot jabbing in to get you up in the air, and she has a nice landing there with a good extension on the free leg, the leg that is off the ice. And this is a perfect layback position. Notice the left foot, that stabilizes her. That's the foot that she's spinning on, and the right foot is turned out nicely, parallel to the ice, and beautiful arm positions throughout.
Well, and Angela's been too distraught to sit in the kiss and cry area. She went backstage, now has made her way back out to hear her marks. The first set, 4.9 to 5.1.
You know, as a skater, you're just devastated when something like this happens. But you do have to sit and take the marks. There's the 10-time world champion, Irina Rodnina. She is now coaching Angela. She was the one responsible for bringing Cherkaskaya to the United States in the first place.
Presentation marks 5.3 up to 5.7. So, Angela Nikodinov still has the lead over Yoshie Onda, but some of the challengers who are right behind Angela, including Yelena Lyashenko, Tatiana Malinina, still to come. When we